it's important for people to see that you can be in pathology and not be a pathologist. My name is Duane Newton. I'm one of the faculty in the Department of Pathology. I'm the director of the Microbiology Lab. I'm also the Associate Division Director for Clinical Pathology. In the Department of Pathology, we have a division of Clinical Pathology, and Clinical Pathology encompasses the areas of the department that perform laboratory testing. So some of the examples are the Hematology Lab and the Chemistry Lab and the Molecular Diagnostics Labs, and Clinical Microbiology Lab is one of those as well. Many of those labs are run by physicians who are MD pathologists. They went to the medical school and did residency programs in pathology and got specific training that provided them with the expertise to run that clinical laboratory. Microbiology is interesting in that most microbiology labs in hospitals in the country are actually run by PhDs who've gotten similar training to me. That's very true as well of chemistry labs, cytogenetics labs, HLA labs that do tissue typing. Those generally are run by PhD scientists who've gotten specific training in those areas, but the laboratories are in departments of pathology. So in a microbiology lab, we're responsible for identifying infections that might be happening or occurring in a patient. So the patient goes to the physician thinks the patient has an infection, they would collect a sample and send that to our lab, and we try to determine what organisms or organism would be causing that infection. So things like strep throat or Lyme disease or tuberculosis or HIV, we would do testing for that to make that diagnosis. And really, my job is not to take care of the individual patient, it's to make sure that everybody's moving in the right direction. And so a lot of what I'm doing is putting teams together to address the problems that come up. I have to know what's going on. I have to know all the parts that people are playing. I have to know how those particular functions are occurring, but really what my role is to make sure that ship is moving in on the right course. So are we using the right technologies? Are we approaching things for the most efficient and cost-effective way for patient care? Are we providing the level of service that we need to for our physicians? We have so many resources available to us to do the things that are important for patient care, but also for me personally and professionally to develop, to do applied research, to develop, help develop new technologies that we might incorporate, to get to teach our pathology residents, to teach med tech students, to teach medical students, to teach even in the folks that are in our lab. Why are we doing the things that we're doing and how can we do them better? That's a really important part of our role as faculty here, and that's something that I really enjoy doing as well.